Hi everyone, and welcome back to Ask the Engineer. I'm pleased to welcome CTO Chris Correro to this episode. Chris, how are you doing?
Great, thanks Jack. Thanks for having me.
No problem at all. Chris, today's question is regarding server faults. More specifically, what can be done to prevent the most common server faults when it comes to hard drives and motherboards?
Absolutely, let's go through each one of them.
Sure.
I guess first on the list would be hard drive failures. The most common hard drive failure probably be mechanical, electrical, even a logical disk failure. These occur when they're either dropped or exposed in an unfavorable environment. If there's a voltage spike, overheating, even data corruption, improper registry changes, accidental drive formatting. When a hard drive fails, admins use common tools like FSCK or a check disk within Windows to check and repair those logical errors. Building redundancies via RAID can also prevent these failures from becoming a real big issue.
Yeah, absolutely. And what about failures from motherboards?
So motherboard failures, those usually include overheating, electrical failures or physical damage, and sometimes even humidity problems. Preventing these types of errors come from ensuring proper airflow to the device, verifying the device is stored at the proper temperature. A static charge, power surge, or even electrical spikes can cause malfunction. Be sure that if you're performing a hot swap, you don't accidentally contact the system or leverage a surge protector or in the environment.
Yeah, absolutely.
Moisture in the air and electronics don't really mix well and can create corrosion and short circuit issues.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, it sounds like there's a lot that could potentially go wrong with servers if you fail to take those preventative measures.
Right.
Chris, thank you so much for your time and sharing this helpful information with our listeners. Remember, guys, just reach out if you have a question for one of our engineers. Until next time, we'll see you on Ask the Engineer.